Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to look at basic progressions of push-ups and pull-ups. So first you'll see here, if you can't do a normal push-up, you should try to do wall push-ups. So these are push-ups where you are standing or almost standing and facing a wall and try to push yourself up. So your chest should always touch the wall in this case. So moving on, we're going to bench push-ups. So you push yourself up from the bench. These are easier than normal push-ups. Always try to use full range of motion here, so your chest should always touch the ground and your arms should fully lock out at each rep. So moving on to normal push-ups, once you can do normal push-ups, you can then move on to do knuckle push-ups, which you see here. So you, instead of your flat hands, you use your knuckles. These are a little bit harder. If you're proficient in using knuckle or doing knuckle push-ups, you can then move on to raise your feet and do incline push-ups. And you can vary the incline angle to make it even harder, the higher the harder. And these are pretty tough if you are not working out regularly. So, okay, and moving on to the last, once you're strong enough to do weighted push-ups, that's where it gets really fun. What I do is I just put the weight on my back and try to find a position where it does not slide off, so my lower back. You should always try to keep yourself, like, your core engaged, and your body should be super stiff so that there is no movement in your lower body. Alright, moving on to pull-ups. Pull-ups can be quite tough for a lot of people, so I always suggest starting with lying pull-ups, like you see here. The key here is the more you move your feet out, the harder they are. So you'll see here, the first version was the easiest, now it gets a little bit harder. It's the center of gravity goes a little bit more forward. So try to not bend your hips here. So your body should actually not move, you should just be in a flat line, your upper body, and you just pull yourself up until you touch the bar, and then go back down and repeat. Once you can do those, you can move on to more normal pull-ups. These are merely jumping pull-ups. So I jump up, hold for a second, and go down as slowly as possible for a few reps. Most people can get it, even if they can not do a pull-up, can get a few reps here. So definitely valuable to try. Yeah, once you get good with those, you can move on to normal pull-ups. So full range of motion here until the shoulders touch the handle at the top. That's how you know there that is full range of motion. You go from a full hang to a touch at the top, and always use a natural repetition speed. Once you get good at those, you can use weighted pull-ups. And weighted pull-ups are very hard, but are very efficient for your back gains. So your lats are gonna like them. Okay guys, thank you for watching, and if you're interested in coaching, shoot me a message or head over to competentcoaching.com, and I'll see you soon. Goodbye.